glad. Troubles don't last always, and I'm so glad. Troubles don't last always. It may not come when you want him, but he's on time. But he's on time. In times of trouble, he's a friend of mine, and I'm so glad. Trouble don't last. Troubles don't last always, and I'm so glad. Troubles don't last always, and I'm so glad. Troubles don't last. Troubles don't last always. Troubles don't last always.
Good morning, friends and church family. On behalf of our pastor, the Reverend Alicia Langhorne, I would like to welcome you to the virtual service for Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church in Silver Spring, Maryland, for this Sunday, April 18th, 2021. We know you have a choice of where to worship on Sunday morning, and we are so glad you have chosen to worship with us today. As you experience today's service, feel free to use the chat or comment box to communicate to us all. And now, let us prepare our hearts and minds for today's worship.
Good morning. Welcome to Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church. On behalf of the members, leaders, and friends of Luther Rice, my name is the Reverend Alicia Langhorne, and I am blessed to serve as the pastor of this beloved place of God. We encourage you to like, to share, to follow us both on Facebook and YouTube, to get into the comments or the chat wherever you are, even if you're on Zoom, and let us know who you are and where you are worshiping from. We believe that if we share the word of God, that God will touch the minds and hearts of all who hear it. I invite you to join us as we continue in our Easter season, time of joint prayer and reflection. It is Easter season in the life of the church. Easter is not just one day. As a matter of fact, as believers, we are considered to be Easter people, but it is especially important during this time, the time between Easter and Pentecost, what I lovingly call the birthday of the church, that we move into a time of prayer, of reflection, so that we, as the body of Christ, the hands and feet of Christ in the world today, can know what God is calling us as the church to be and to do, So I invite you, particularly those who are members of Luther Rice or friends of Luther Rice, what I call members light, or those who are seeking to know what it is that God is calling them to do and how they can make an impact in the world around them. I invite you to journey with us from now until May 23rd, praying, asking God about what it is that God is calling you to do. I invite you to reflect on the things that you are good at, the things that you want to see the church do in the world. Because then in the following month, we will have time where you can have FaceTime with the pastor, where we're calling Let Us Imagine Together, so that we can imagine together what God is calling us to be in the world around us. I want to thank each and every person that prayed for or that actually came out to help in our food distribution on this week. Our young people who have been the backbone of this operation in some ways for our distribution part were not available this week. But let me tell you, the people of Luther Rice and our friends came through. Some individuals took off from work. Others who show up every single time made sure they came and they came early. And even those who just came to visit to see how we do things decided to come in and give help. We are especially grateful for our volunteers that every single week come in during the week to pack our bags that we give out. We would not be able to do this. We would not be able to feed God's people right now without the help of each and every one of you. I also thank every person that sends a donation that consistently prays for us. So we know that it is God who does exceedingly abundantly more than we could ask, think, or imagine. And through our neighborhood center food pantry, we are doing exceedingly abundantly more than we even prayed for. So again, we thank you for worshiping with us today. We know that it wasn't by accident, but by God's divine providence that you are here.
Church announcements. Pastor Alicia will have office hours on Monday, April 19th from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. The pandemic media team will meet on Monday, April 19th at 6:30 p.m. Wednesday, April 21st, we will have our monthly trustees meeting beginning at 6 o'clock p.m. And then Friday, April 23rd, we will have another installment of our Enjoy program from 1 to 3 p.m. This week's Enjoy session will focus on how you can become a master of your Googleverse. What is Google? How does it work? How can I make the Drive, Maps, Sheets work for me? Our senior techs and a special guest speaker will go over all you need to get the most out of your Google experience. So again, our Enjoy session will be this Friday, April 23rd from 1 to 3 o'clock p.m. Also, don't forget, our Enjoy Ministries also has weekly office hours. So if you're having a technology issue, feel free to reach out to one of our senior techs at either of the following email addresses, seniortech@lutherricechurch.org or enjoy@lutherricechurch.org. The office hours for our tech services are Wednesday from 1:30 to 3:30 or Fridays from 3 to 5. And then we will round out the week with our Neighborhood Center food distribution on Saturday, April 24th. Please plan to arrive at 10:30 a.m. to help set up for our giveaway, which begins at 11. Again, our distribution runs from 11 a.m. to 2 o'clock p.m., and we appreciate all the hands and help we can get. And then, coming up next Sunday, April 25th, immediately following our church service, we will have our quarterly business meeting. So please stay on the Zoom line after service for this important meeting. Again, next Sunday, immediately following church service on Zoom. Our reading challenge for the next 4 weeks is to read the resurrection narratives in the New Testament. This week, we will focus on the narrative from John chapter 20. As you read the narratives, discern the similarities and the differences in each. Also, we are still looking for readers for our virtual service. We need people who are willing to video and record themselves reading the scripture for our Sunday virtual services. The church will provide the scriptures. All you have to do is read. Also, our senior techs from the Enjoy Ministry can help you with the recording. So, if you're interested, please reach out to our church office to sign up. Looking for further connection with Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church? We invite you to use the virtual connection and prayer request cards. All links can be found in the chat box on Zoom and on our Facebook and YouTube page. Need information on any of these church activities? Please call or email the church office at 301-593-1130 or email office@lutherricechurch.org.
Now let us join in today for the call to worship. I'll read where the light print, I invite you to join in on the dark print. This new day is fresh with possibility to encounter the living Christ. With bright eyes, let us search. This new day is fresh with possibility to understand the living Christ. With engaged minds, let us ponder. This new day is fresh with possibility to be moved by the living Christ. With compassionate hearts, let us feel. This new day is fresh with the possibility to respond to the living Christ. With silent devotion, let us follow. This new day is fresh with possibility to serve the living Christ. With humble intention, let us act. This new day is fresh with possibility to praise the living Christ. With strong voices, let us sing. Let us pray together. Gracious and almighty God, we thank you for the wonder of your presence. We thank you for the ability to worship together virtually. Through time and space, you are gathering your people in this moment. Allow us, wherever we're watching, to be touched by the living Christ. Let us encounter you in word, thought, and love, and let us carry you out to the world. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ, I invite all God's people everywhere to say amen.
Is
is now time to worship through giving and to pledge our support to the work of God in this church and the wonderful ministries we serve. For our virtual services, we have several ways you can give. Feel free to use PayPal and the address treasurer@lutherricechurch.org, or you can reach us by mail at 801 University Boulevard West, Silver Spring, Maryland 20901, or via Cash App and the address $Luther Rice Memorial. Remember, for our electronic giving, always look for the steeple to know you're in the right place. Feel free to reach out to our senior tech at lutherricechurch.org if you need any assistance with electronic payments. We thank you for your continued giving and support of our church, church ministries, and those we serve.
Let us pray. Creator God, we know that you've made everything in this world to satisfy all our needs. You have been so generous to all every day. We pray that this church will show our generosity in giving back to you what is already yours. May we always give our gift to you as a thank offering for the magnificent gift of Jesus that you so generally give to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks.
As we gather our hearts and mind and turn ourselves to a time of prayer, there is always much to pray about and many to pray for. And if you're like me this week, your heart may be especially heavy as we think about our brothers and sisters and all that has happened in Chicago and Minneapolis, Minnesota, in Indianapolis, Indiana, and even in Honolulu, Hawaii. And I'm sure there are some places I'm missing. There is so much that is happening in our world. There is so much that happens each and every day in the communities that we live in and communities we've never even thought about or even had a moment to go visit. But we are a global community. So it is incumbent upon us who believe in the power of prayer to pray. To pray so that then our actions will align with our words. And our deeds will flow out of our hearts. I ask you to continue to lift up Sister Julie and all of those who are grieving from the loss of their loved ones. I invite you to pray for all of those who have loved ones or who themselves are suffering from COVID-19. People are still getting sick. People are still having adverse reactions to the vaccine. We thank God that the numbers are as small as they are. And I'm also asking each and every one of you to pray that all of our hearts and attitudes will be one of loving care and kindness, no matter what people's choices are to take the vaccine or not. Let us learn how to treat each other as brothers and sisters and all as the beloved of God. I invite you right now to call out the name of a friend, a loved one, maybe a name you saw in the news this week. Call them up and lift their name up high before God to heaven. And I invite you, if right now you are going through, to call your own name out. I promise that we won't tell. We call those names out. or we say the situations that we want God to take care of, not because we don't believe that God will do it, not because we think that God can't hear us, but to remind ourselves that God knows, that God hears, and that God is always acting in the hearts, in the minds of the people who call themselves the people of God. Let us pray. O Lord, our rock, our hearts rejoice in you. Holy One, our strength rises up with joy in your deliverance. You know our every action, and you lift up those who stumble. We pray that your peace would shatter the weapons of war, that your justice would humble those who fill themselves to overflowing, that those who are starving would find food in abundance. We pray for lives that feel barren, for hearts that are bereaved, for all who are trapped by the power of death. We pray for these dear ones who are close to our hearts. God, we pray that you will help us to be the people who will provide comfort for those who feel all alone in the world, to provide food for those who are hungry, to provide clean water for those who are thirsty. We pray that you will help us to not just pray, but that you will use us to be the solution to someone else's prayer. You, Lord, turn death into life. You, Lord, turn poverty into wealth and tear down the unjust wealth that drives others into poverty. When the world sweeps away those who are poor like dust, and tosses out those in need as if they were garbage, you lift them up and restore them to honor. Help us to have hearts and minds that want to be the ones who lift up those who are in need, who tear down unjust systems that look at people based upon what they have and the color of their skin. We pray to you, who we know have established the pillars of earth, guard our hearts and guide our feet, that so that we might be now and ever faithful to your world-transforming faithfulness. We pray in Jesus' name, all of us who seek your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you for the Reverend Nathaniel Williams, for whose prayer we have lifted up and entwined with our own today. God, we love you, we worship you, we adore you. In Jesus' name, all God's people say together, amen.
You're my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my own. Be a fool, you are my all in all. Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again, I bless your name. You are my all in all. When I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all.
This Sunday scriptures is coming from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, verses 13 through 35. The walk to Emmaus. I'll be reading from the New Revised Standard Version of the Bible. Let us hear the word of the Lord. Now on that same day, two of them were walking to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem, and talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing, Jesus himself came near and went with them. But their eyes were kept from recognizing him. And he said to them, "What are you discussing with each other while you walk along?" They stood still, looking sad. Then one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?" He asked them, "What things?" They replied, "The things about Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty indeed, and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hope that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead of, as if he was going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, because it is almost evening, and the day is now nearly over.' So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening the scriptures to us?' That same hour, they go up and return to Jerusalem. They found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, 'The Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon.' Then they told what happened on the road and how they had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Pastor Alicia invited me here today. I told her I'm no preacher now. All I can do is tell my part of the story. Now, I know some of you are surprised to see me. You know that. And probably won't even know my name. But if Luke didn't bother to give it to you, then I don't have to either. I bet others you're surprised that I'm a woman, right? Well, there are some people in your time, like their Dr. Sharon Remy, who correctly surmised that I was the one along the road with Cleophas on the road to Emmaus. And again, I just want to remind you now, again, before I tell my part of the story, what I experienced, and I'm no preacher, I'm just telling you what I went through, what I witnessed. So, I know you people that are 22,000 years later, you think you know me. You think you would have known what to do and how to respond. Well, I invite you, if you really want to know what happened, if you want to know what I experienced on the journey to Emmaus, I invite you to lean in, to come closer, to hear what happened for me on that fateful day. So many years ago. Now, yes, I gotta be honest. We were only trying to get out. Get out. Flight or fight. Because they were after us. And they had already taken Jesus, the one who had taught us so much, the one who had cared for us so well. They caught him, locked him up, and hung him up. And just when I could finally get to sleep, after being up crying all night, here come my sisters, the other women that were among us, telling us that Jesus' body was gone. Now, no, that I might have could have handled. But then those chief priests and those guards started spreading rumors that we, the disciples, the one who hung with Jesus, took his body all just to make him look bad. And that's when me and Cleophas realized now was the time to get out. We just knew we had to get out of Jerusalem. And Emmaus was just far enough to be close enough to get word when it might be time to come back. As a matter of fact, today I started to talk to you really about getting out. But I decided to share with you today again instead about how to lean in when circumstances and situations are changing. I mean, we went from walking alongside Jesus, watching the miracles happen, the feeding. I mean, I ate some of the fish. I saw the baskets and loaves that were left over. I saw the crowds throwing off the palms as we made our way into Jerusalem. But I also saw how they beat them, how they lied on them, how the same people who were saying, "We love you, we adore you, you're our king, you know, Hosanna, Hosanna," did turn and say, "Crucify him, crucify him." And though some of you would say you never turn your back on him, I know what it was like to be looked at as one of those followers of his. To have your name being talked about, to know that you're on the scrolls of the ones that the chief priests would no longer speak to. And we knew, we all knew that it was just about to get worse. That even though they'd gotten him, they next be coming for us. So we decided we were going to Emmaus. We were getting out of town. I don't care what you thought you would have done. I'm telling you what we did. And as we walked, we started out, I don't think we had gotten very far. Me and Cleophas, and yeah, again, I'm not telling you my name. Luke didn't, so I don't have to either. We're talking about what had happened. You know, and I wasn't the only one on that roll crying and upset. And I'll be honest with you, I'm not usually that nice to strangers. Even though the guy came up asking us where were we going and what had happened, I wasn't inclined to respond because I just had too many thoughts in my head. I was still scared. I didn't know what had happened. I was sad. I mean, what if somebody that you like was killed, crucified in front of you? What would you have done? So yeah, I had learned to be nice to strangers and, you know, we're all in this together, but I didn't feel like it then. And so I actually thought he was being a little nosy. But that Cleophas, always talking and speaking to everybody. So when he asked him what we were talking about and why we looked so sad, Cleophas said, "Hey, are you the only visitor in Jerusalem? Are you the only person who doesn't know what happened? What's happening these days? And with this stranger, I mean, you know, there was nothing special about him except he seemed to be clueless. Like, where did you come from? Some rock or something? Where did you come from?" So anyway, but you know, when he asked us what things, we started talking about Jesus from Nazareth, how he was so mighty, not just in what he said, but what he did. He didn't just talk about being nice to people. He was nice. I saw him heal a friend of mine. She had been coming to that temple every single Sabbath, all hunched over and twisted and turned around. Every single Sabbath, every time we gathered, people saw her. We all felt bad for her. And then the day when Jesus came, he went over to her. He saw her. He talked to her. He touched her. He told her to straighten up. He even reminded her. Matter of fact, he reminded all of us that she was also a daughter of Abraham, our ancestor. I won't go there though. And she straightened right up. And don't you know, those temple leaders and chief priests were mad about that. So anyway, we're telling this guy who comes up because he acted like he didn't know anything. And the more we talked about how, you know, he did all these great things. We talked about how they were kept trying to set him up when we were at the temple. I gotta admit, I liked it. I liked it when the people like the Sadducees who didn't believe in the afterlife started asking questions about heaven. How are you gonna ask questions about heaven? You don't even believe there's a heaven. What? But anyway, I enjoyed that. But then we talked about the fake trial, the mockery. We talked about how without even a real trial, you know, real witnesses coming in that knew him, that saw what happened, they found him guilty. They condemned him to death. And then it was almost like we blinked, and there he was, hanging up on that cross. The more we talked about it, the more it hurt. The more I remember what it felt like to be excited. And though it was literally only 3 days ago, it felt like a whole lifetime ago. It felt like a whole nother time. And then, if that weren't enough, some of my sister girls came telling us that his body was gone, that they had seen him. Now, you know, I am inclined to believe my sisters. If they said it, so is so. But, I mean, I saw him up on that cross. I saw him hang his head. I saw him die and breathe the last breath. I even saw when Joseph of Arimathea gave up the tomb for him. So I just don't understand when they came back saying that they saw him. And then, you know, some of the disciples, some of us, some of them went to the tomb. They didn't see a body either. Again, that's when me and Cleophas was like, you know what? We got to go. I mean, we left for two reasons. Because we were afraid And because we were so sad, I mean, to watch the one who you thought was going to change things, to watch the one who you saw making a difference be killed in such a way, the one who you knew was finally going to make things right, the one who you've been praying for, you've been hoping for, you've been out telling other people about. We were going from town to town telling them about this Jesus of Nazareth. You should have seen them stand up to those people. Ha! Tell them that the way they were treating us wasn't right, it wasn't fair, as women, as poor people. Ha! We had hoped. But it didn't work out that way. So we decided to go. And I'm not mad about it. That was the right decision for us at the time. So then we're telling this stranger all these things. You know, we're being honest, authentic, letting them know the stuff that didn't add up, why we were doubting, why we were grieving, you know, why we didn't understand. Like, we saw this part, but we didn't understand that part. We were honest. We were authentic. And I'm not usually, let me just tell you, that open to strangers. But because of all I had going on, because of all I had seen, because of all I had hoped for, I knew then was a good time to just let it all out. I think you call it vulnerable. Yes, but I wasn't the only one. Cleophas was too. Have you ever had somebody correct you, but they do it in a way that you don't feel mad, that you can tell they're not talking down to you? So when this stranger said to us that we were foolish and slow of heart, it didn't feel like an insult. Matter of fact, it wasn't an insult, because he then wants to explain what those scriptures, you know, what those, all those things they taught us in Hebrew school, all those things we had to memorize, how they all said that the one who we were waiting for, the one who we were hoping, would have to suffer. And he's telling us this, and I'm listening, and I'm like, oh, that sounds familiar. Other things, I'm like, I don't know if I remember. Maybe I missed that day. And so he keeps telling us about all these scriptures and these stories. And then he actually makes it make sense. So I started to accept that this guy, this stranger, he knew a little something. I mean, you know, he started with Moses and then took us all the way through the prophets. I mean, like, I don't even know what's left. I mean, he told us so much that we didn't even realize that we were almost too amazed. We were almost where we were going. As a matter of fact, we were probably maybe a mile, quarter of a mile, 2 miles from our destination. And then he wants to leave us. He's acting like, you know, he's going to leave now. How you going to come and drop all this knowledge? Have us to accept what you're saying after being authentic, and then you're just going to leave us? No, no, no. Mm-mm. We knew that. I knew. Let me be honest. Remember I told you I wasn't that excited about him being with us at the beginning. So I was like, you know what? Come on. Come on with us. It's late in the day. Come on back to the house. We got somewhere set up to stay. And we can feed you at least. Come on. You know, my mother would have been proud. So we went in the house, we sat down, you know, washed the dust off our feet from the long walk, and set the table out, you know. But here where it got a little strange again. Now, he's our guest, right? He doesn't have the table, but it's okay, because you know what? He was with us today. He helped us. You know, even though we were talking about old stuff, it made the new stuff make more sense. So then we sit down, we're gonna say, you know, bless the bread and so we can eat. And he, again, a little strange for our time, he reaches for the bread. Picks up the bread, blesses the bread, and then he gets ready to break it. And all of a sudden, I'm like, sit at the table, blessing the bread, break it. I've seen this before. I've heard this. And all of a sudden, it was like, how did I miss it? Jesus was there. Jesus was with us. Right at that moment, we realized that he was there. It was like praying. Oh, Jesus! And just as soon as it hit us, he was gone. But we were so excited that that Cleophas and I were like, I'm telling you, just like I told Cleophas, like Cleophas told me. So we were walking and we were talking and we were walking and we were talking. I felt a little something here. It felt a little different. It felt like, I mean, even though we were talking about such hard stuff, I could feel a little different. It felt like as we talked, somehow we started to feel better. To then find out, to realize that Jesus was with us all the way. Don't you know we got up fast and we ran back to Jerusalem. We had to find the other ones and tell them that yes, my girls, my sisters, they had it right. That Jesus was in fact alive. And when we went, they were hiding in the room. They were all together. And we told them, said, the Lord has risen. We asked them, just like I'm asking you today, just lean in, listen to the story. We were walking. We were authentic. We were being honest about how we felt, what we were experiencing. You know, we accepted what he was, even though the stranger who we now know is Jesus, was telling us, you know, stories that were familiar. He said it in a new way. And we accepted what he was saying. Helped us to put all the pieces together. And then we wanted to acknowledge what he gave us. What he shared with us. Just this time, the wisdom. Even before we knew that it was Jesus, we were proud of that fact. That we accepted what he said. We acknowledged his graciousness. What he shared, the knowledge, and then to find out it was Jesus. So we started telling them that, you know, all we have to do is be honest with each other. Tell each other what's going on, what's really happening. And if we do it again, maybe Jesus will show up again. And teach us some more things. I gotta tell you, that was the first time in a long time, in at least a couple of weeks, that I felt like I was in the right place. That I felt like, even though things hadn't worked out the way I thought they were going to work out. Because let me just tell you, I wasn't expecting somebody to get killed to change things up. I was expecting somebody to get a new army, to bum rush it, and then we would win. But I started to understand that in a different way, things still could change. I realized that I had heard Jesus when he said, whatever you do for the least of these, you do it unto me. We didn't know that stranger that we welcomed, that we accepted, that we acknowledged what they were saying was Jesus, but it was. So if there's nothing else you get from a story, if there's nothing else you hear, gotta just share with you to be honest, be authentic, even when the person is a stranger. Even when you don't think you can help them or do anything for them. Just listen. Just share. Discuss your problems. Tell them. Invite them in. Because you never know that when they sit at the table, you might just get a peek of Jesus. Now, I know some of you said, I want to know, how do you see Jesus? How do you get to a place that when you're going through a hard time, Jesus shows up? The only thing I can tell you is to do what we did. Be honest with each other. Share what you're missing. Share about the things you hoped for, the things you hoped that would happen, that you didn't see come to pass. If you do that, sharing one with another, opening yourselves up to the strangers that may show up in the midst, you might just, when you truly walk on them, see Jesus. I'm convinced. That's what I'm here to tell you. That leaning in, that being authentic is about being authentic with how you feel, being honest. It's about accepting what someone else has to say. Even when it sounds sort of familiar, but different. And then if you can just accept them though, maybe you can't accept what they're saying, but you can acknowledge that they're human, that they have a need, and invite them into your space. Then Jesus will show up in the midst. So if you need Jesus to show up, then there are some good people at that church, and I think it's Luther Rice something. Luther Rice Memorial. Luther Rice Memorial. I got it, Pastor Regina. Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church, who are willing and waiting with arms stretched wide open to welcome you, to invite you to sit at the table to eat with them. And if you want to be with them, eat with them, be in community with them, no matter where you are, they got this newfangled thing called email. You can email them at deacons@lutherricechurch.org. And they will walk alongside you. They are excited about wanting to be with you. And they are praying and believing that Jesus will show up. And I'm a witness. That at the moment when you feel like all hope is gone, when everything that could have went left, that when you're honest about what happens, when you share your story, when you share what you're going through, that Jesus shows up. So if you need Jesus to show up and lead and guide you, now is the time and today is the day. So even as I close, I'm still not telling you my name since Luke didn't, but also because you could be me. And all you have to do is be willing to be authentic, acknowledge other folks, accept them, and lean in. Let us pray. Gracious and almighty God, we pray that you take what we offer to you with our creative hearts and our minds as an acceptable offering, as an acceptable witness to the goodness and the graciousness and the love that you have for all humankind. In the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ, let us together say amen. We pray that some way, somehow, God spoke to you during today's broadcast. We pray that your heart, your mind, your spirit, and your soul was reminded what it means to be Easter people and to live in the midst of transition. I invite you to click, like, share, follow us both on Facebook and YouTube. Join us now in our closing prayer. I now invite you to join us in our closing prayer. Please take a prayer posture in your heart, but keep your eyes on the screen and join us. Let us pray. Lord, the resurrection of your Son has given us new life and renewed hope. Help us to live as new people in pursuit of the Christian ideal of love and action. Grant us the wisdom to know what we must do, the will to want to do it, the courage to undertake it, the perseverance to continue to do it, and the strength to complete it. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us all say together, amen. And now this is our benediction. May the loving power of God, which raised Jesus to new life, strengthen you in hope, enrich you with his love, and fill you with joy in the faith. Until the Lord allows us to gather together again, may God bless you and keep you. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. 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 Let the church say amen. Church said, amen. Let the church say, amen. 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 Amen.
Thank you to our friends, visitors, and church family for joining us today. We are so glad you chose to worship with Luther Rice Memorial Baptist Church this morning. to Pastor Alicia, Brother Dwayne, the Pandemic Media Team, our church soloists and psalmists, everyone who participated in and prayed for this virtual service, we thank you so very much. Remember, things are loosening up, but we must remain vigilant to help stop the spread. By what? Remembering the three W's. You guys know what they are. Wear your mask, wash your hands, and watch your distance. Let us all continue to stay positive so we can test negative. We look forward to seeing you all right back here next Sunday, starting at 9:30 a.m. for Sunday school, 11 a.m. for service, and immediately following our church service next week, we will have our quarterly business meeting. Have a great day, everybody. We look forward to seeing you right back here next Sunday. Bye-bye.